creatures of our God and King. Lift up your voice and with us sing. Alleluia, alleluia. Oh, burning sun with golden beam, and silver moon with softer gleam. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia.
Glory. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, clothe yourselves with humility in your dealings with one another, for God opposes the proud, but bestows favor on the humble. So humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your worries upon him, because he cares for you. Be sober and vigilant. Your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in faith, knowing that your brothers and sisters throughout the world undergo the same sufferings. The God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory through Christ Jesus, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you after you have suffered a little. To him be dominion forever. Amen. I write you this briefly through Silvanus, whom I consider a faithful brother, exhorting you and testifying that this is the true grace of God. Remain firm in it. The chosen one of Babylon sends you greeting, as does Mark, my son. Greet one another with a loving kiss. Peace to all of you who are in Christ. The word of the Lord. The favors of the Lord I will sing forever through all generations, and my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness, for you have said, my kindness is established forever. In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Hallelujah.
The heavens proclaim your wonders, O Lord, and your faithfulness in the assembly of the holy ones. For who in the skies can rank with the Lord? Who is like the Lord among the sons of God? Blessed the people who know the joyful shout in the light of your countenance. O Lord, they walk. At your name they rejoice all the day, and through your justice they are exalted. Some of the miraculous things that they performed in order to testify to what God his plan is and its truth. But we also get to hear a rare letter from St. Peter in our liturgy. And we hear a lot of really good, sound advice here. You know, and perhaps the one that I needed to hear today is, cast all your worries upon him because he cares for you. And ultimately, this is so much of what we want to hear when we open the book and we're looking for God to speak to us. And he, in addition to Peter wanting to let us know that God is listening, that he is there, he also is encouraging us to be sober and vigilant. Because the devil is out looking for ways to pull people down. We always say a phrase that goes like this, misery loves company. And so much of what the devil does is because he's living out that doctrine. And he wants to pull other people down with him because of his spite for God and God's creation. And so we don't want to fall victim to that. And this is one of the efforts that Peter is trying to warn us about, but to also encourage us so that we don't get lured away by him from the path that we're on. And it's a lot easier to stay on the path when times are good and things are going swimmingly. Much more difficult it is when we're faced with adversity, with grief, with suffering, to want to be lured away from that path by a promise of a quick fix or some other way that will help you that is not from God. And you want to be sober and vigilant and resist the devil and his invitations. So let us pray through the intercession of St. Mark and the other evangelists that will hear the word of God, not the word of the evil. Knowing of the Father's great love for us, we offer our prayers with confidence and trust. For all members of the Church, may God bless our efforts to proclaim the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for areas of the world struggling for peace within their borders, may the Holy Spirit lead them in building just societies for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died, may they find eternal rest in heaven with all the angels and saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And on this feast day of St. Mark, let us pray for the mass intention of today, which is for all military, healthcare workers, first responders, and grocery store workers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, you have asked us to lift our prayers to you. We ask that upon hearing them, you may respond in mercy and love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, as we venerate the glory of St. Mark, we offer
your Spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now in praises and ending with all the host of angels, we sing to you with our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant your peace to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here, we stand in devotion and honor to you. For them, we offer you the sacrifice of praise that they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hand. And with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, as Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and eat, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones who are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek. a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and help us live in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, to those sinners, open your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some shared fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, now and in our merits. But grant us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, Lord, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Behold, I am with you always, even to the end of the age, says the Lord. Alleluia. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in the faith of the gospel which Saint Mark proclaimed, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Tell the good news. Go out to all.